chairman of the House Republican Conference, a gentleman from Indiana, Mike Pence. I want to thank Eric Cantor for his strong leadership on behalf of the U.S.-Israel Alliance. I want to thank Ambassador Corey Gold for his clarion call today. And to my colleagues, Ms. Rooney, Ms. Ross Layton, and Mr. McKeon. I'm honored to stand with our colleagues and say here on the eve of a week that will see the president of the discredited and terrorist-supporting regime in Iran come to the United Nations. The time is now for Congress to enact the strongest possible sanctions against the regime in Iran. As Ambassador Gold just recited, the prospect of a regime in Iran in possession of usable nuclear weapons that could be fired at our cherished ally, Israel, represents a grave threat not only to our ally, but to the vital national interest of the United States of America, and it must be opposed in the strongest legislative terms. Now, this administration has called for engagement with Iran. Let me be clear, engagement and negotiations are not mutually exclusive with sanctions. I respect the ability of the President of the United States to set the diplomatic terms of our nation on the world stage. But it is imperative that this Congress, representing the people of the United States, send a clear and unambiguous message that the people of America will not tolerate a nuclear Iran. I call on our Democrat colleagues in Congress to bring the Iran Petroleum Sanctions Act to the floor this week. It will pass by an overwhelming bipartisan measure, and it will send the precise, correct message to the president of Iran and to the world stage that the American people mean business when we say we will stand for a nuclear-free